Midwestern women, including women in Kansas City, were strangers of fashion trends in the first decades of the 20th century. House dresses were worn by women who didn't work outside of home. With minimum talent and a sewing machine, a new industry began at first. It was a small operation. A designer named Nell Donnelly significantly changed the fashion style in Kansas City.
Terrence O'Malley is the great-great-nephew of Nell. He's a Kansas City lawyer and wrote Nelly Don, A Stitch in Time and Nelly Don the Musical.
It used to be if a woman was going to wear a nice dress, she would wear it, say, out shopping on Saturday or to church on Sunday. And the way the dresses were made was there would be a dress shop, and you would go into the dress shop and there would be a catalog, books of dresses, and you would flip through the books, pick out a design that you liked, they'd measure you up, and you'd come back in 3 or 4 weeks and they'd have your dress ready for you.
Nell Quinlan was born in Parsons, Kansas. She was the 12th of 13 children. Her Irish father immigrated from County Cork, Ireland to work on the railroad. At an early age, Nell learned to sew clothes for her family and created dresses for her dolls. She later learned the art of dressmaking using hand-me-down clothing. After graduating high school in Parsons, Kansas, Nell moved to Kansas City where she got a job as a stenographer. Nell met a man named Paul Donnelly who lived in the same boarding house and was also a stenographer. She married him in 1906 at the age of 17 and he was 23.
I think that Nell and Paul were genuinely in love when they first got married, which was in 1907. And so for the first many years of their marriage, I think it was a satisfying relationship. Paul was, by all accounts, was a very nice person, was a good person.
In 1907, Nell and Paul made the decision to pool their money together so she can go away to college for 2 years to pursue her education. She graduated from Lindenwood College in St. Charles, Missouri, and then returned to Kansas City in 1909. Nell stepped into the role of a housewife at a young age. She didn't like the idea of wearing shapeless, expensive, and unflattering dresses at the time. Wanting a more stylish and expensive women's dress, she began making her own clothing. It was 1916 when she made a dozen dress springs designed to allow women to move freely during physical activity. After getting rejected by a few stores in town to sell her dresses, there was finally a home for them at Peck Dry Goods at 12th and Main Street, Kansas City. On the first day, every single dress was sold and the buyer ordered several dozen more. Nell Donnelly sold these everyday dresses for $1 each. Paul Donnelly used his savings to buy two power machines and Nell hired two girls to help and was soon making two dozen dress aprons a day. When Paul Donnelly returned from World War I in 1917, the business outgrew their attic and moved to a location at 1828 Walnut Street in downtown Kansas City, Missouri, and named the building the Donnelly Garment Company. Paul became president of the new company while his wife was secretary treasurer. The name Nelly Don was chosen and appeared on her advertisements. Their company prospered in the 1920s and grew to about 1,000 employees and grossed $3 to $5 million a year. As more orders came in, Nelly had dresses made in selections, styles, and sizes. Paul Donnelly threatened to kill himself if Nelly ever became pregnant. Nelly convinced him, and she adopted a child in Europe for the sake of their figures in their industry and named their baby son David in 1931.
On December 16, 1931, Nelly Don and her chauffeur, named George Blair, were having a normal and typical Wednesday afternoon getting ready to come home. While in the process of pulling up to the driveway in Nelly Don's home, they witnessed strange-looking men surrounding her house. They were wearing hoods over their heads, and from what it looked like in person's eyes, they were having car problems. Out of the kindness of George Blair's heart, he decided to get out of the car and try to help them out so that they could leave and move along. When all of a sudden, out of nowhere, one of the men pulls out a gun and takes George Blair and Nelly Don away in that same car that supposedly did not work. When throwing them in the car, they tied their hands together and pulled bags over their heads so that they would not be able to see. They physically abused her in the car so that she would be left unconscious, and while doing that, the kidnappers switched cars so that the evidence would not follow them. Nelly Don's financial success made her a target for kidnappers who wanted ridiculous amounts of money.
Nell was definitely not involved in something she should not have been. She was the innocent victim of a stupid kidnapping plot.
They threatened to blind her and kill her driver Paul if her husband contacted the police or did not pay the ransom of $75,000. While being held hostage in a farmhouse at Bonner Springs, Kansas, they realized that there were other victims as well being held hostage in the four rooms of the farmhouse. Her second husband after Paul Donnelly, James A. Reed, a Democratic politician. He had good relations with Kansas City Chief Tom Pendergast. James Reed convinced John Lazia, a local mobster, to organize an extrajudicial search for the kidnappers. Lazia's agents located and released Nelly Don along with George Blair 2 days after the kidnapping. And later, the police located the three kidnappers in South Africa, which was where they were from.
After being found, they were returned to America and sentenced to prison for life.
About a year after her kidnapping, Nelly Don divorced Paul Donnelly. She bought 50% of her husband's share in the garment company, and Paul Donnelly went on his way. Although she didn't retire, she continued to be an active worker along with her 1,250 employees. There are to be more surprises. On December 13, 1933, Nelly Don married James Reed. Nelly Don's supposedly adopted child was her biological son. She hid her pregnancy and ran off to Europe because the biological father of the child was James Reed, the Donnelly's lawyer. Their beautiful marriage lasted nearly 11 years until Reed died from pneumonia in 1944. In 1956, Nell sold her interest in the Donnelly Company and it was renamed Nelly Don Incorporated. Her designs were known everywhere for being wearable, sensible, attractive dresses at a price women could afford. Nell brought style to the lower and middle class. She had special insight as a woman and was able to build an empire. Being one of the few women millionaires, Nell Donnelly Reed influenced the fashion industry around the world to come.